In the last training video film module, we had shown you the incoming examination of the diesel locomotive, the prescribed A, B, and C schedules of the engine and its related components, and the expressor. In this training video film module, we will show you the prescribed A, B, and C maintenance schedules of the various assemblies of the radiator room, the air brake system, and the undergear of the locomotive. We will now talk about the A, B, and C schedules of these mechanical sub-assemblies one by one. In the radiator room, we will talk about the radiator fan and its drive and the RTTM blower assembly. In the A schedule of the radiator fan, rotate the radiator fan blades manually. The movement of the fan blades should be free. Then press the radiator fan blades gently with your hand. There should be no play in the radiator fan bearing races. Also, all the radiator fan U-clamps should be present. If any clamp is missing or is damaged, put a new clamp as is being shown to you. The radiator fan outer mesh should be in proper condition. If any breakage is seen, repair or replace as required. Check the journal cross bearing and the spline shaft of the universal shaft. There should be no excessive play in the shaft. Now, apply recommended lubricant to the universal shaft cross joints. Next, rotate the ECC inner spider and check whether there is rubbing between the ECC inner spider and the drum. If there is rubbing between the two, take appropriate action and rectify. In the B schedule of the radiator fan and its drive, open the Allen screw of the radiator fan gearbox unit. If oil seeps out of the radiator fan gearbox unit, the oil level in the gearbox is optimum. If the oil does not seep out, top up with recommended oil. In the A schedule of the RTTM blower, check the blower bearing condition. If it is overheated, send it for overhaul. Check both the adapter nuts of the RTTM blower bearing. Ensure that the adapter nut is completely tightened. And the lock washer one prong is properly fitted into the notch of the lock adapter. Also ensure that the cap bolts of the RTTM blower bearing are completely tightened. Next, assess the condition of the RTTM blower V-belts. Even if one belt is frayed, change all the six belts of the RTTM blower. This will ensure that all the belts in the set are matched. Also assess the tension of the RTTM blower V-belts. If the belts are too loose or are too tight. Adjust the tension of the V-belts. First, loosen all the blower holding bolts of the RTTM blower and adjust the RTTM blower V-belt tension by the adjusting bolt located in the expressor room. Open the lock nut of the adjusting bolt. Then adjust the V-belt tension with the adjusting bolt. After having adjusted the V-belt tension, lock the lock nut properly. Now, assess the tension of the V-belts again. It should deflect 3/4 of an inch approximately when pressed gently with the hand. Now, tighten all the blower holding bolts again. Finally, grease the RTTM blower bearings and ensure that the old grease does not fall in the blower casing. In the C schedule of the RTTM blower assembly, check the alignment of the RTTM blower belt pulleys. Apply the straight edged rule on the face of the larger pulley and extend it to the blower pulley. If the straight edged rule matches the faces of both the pulleys, the alignment of the RTTM blower belts is proper with the pulleys. In the A schedule of the air brake system, clean the elements of the VA-1B control valve. Open the VA-1B control valve cover and take out its spool valve, the spool valve guide, and the pusher pin. Clean all these elements with recommended solvent and soak them with a clean lintless cloth. Now, put the components back one by one. Put back the diaphragm and tighten the cover properly. Check the air hose coupling, its rubber sealing, and its clamps. All of them should be in proper condition. In the C schedule of the air brake system, take out the J filter housing and remove the J filter element from its housing. Now, put a new filter. Change the J filter O-ring and fit it back in the underframe. In the underframe of the locomotive, we will talk about the A, B, and C schedules of the traction motor gear case, traction motor suspension arrangement, the brake block, the axle box, wheels, and the other undergear safety components. First, carry out a general check of all the safety components fitted in the undergear system. If any nut or bolt of any of the components is missing, tighten it fully. And if any part is missing or is damaged, fit a new or an overhauled part. In the A schedule of traction motor gear keys, after the locomotive comes to the pit, open the traction motor gear case cap and insert a level gauge into the filling hole of the gear case and check the level of the cardium compound. If the level of cardium compound is below the prescribed level, top up with cardium compound. Ensure that there is no overfilling of the cardium compound. After this, fit the cap properly and repeat this procedure for the gear case of all the traction motors. Next, check the traction motor gear case nuts and bolts for tightness. Tighten all the loose nuts and bolts. Ensure that split pin is always present. Also ensure that safety clamps are present on each bolt to protect it from falling down on run. In the C schedule of the traction motor gear case, torque the gear case mounting bolt and the gear case joint bolt with a torque wrench. The gear case mounting bolt should torque at 140 to 160 kgm and the joint bolt should torque at 25 kgm. In the A schedule of the traction motor suspension arrangement, visually examine the fixing arrangement of the traction motor suspension nose guide bolts. The traction motor noses must be properly placed on the suspension pads. In the A schedule of the brake block, check the brake block. If it is damaged or has reached its critical size, replace with a new brake block. If this is not done, the brake shoe will rub with the wheels and will get damaged and will damage the wheel profile on run. After changing the brake block, ensure that the two ends of the split pins in the brake pull rod are adequately opened. Next, adjust the brake slack adjuster by loosening or tightening the adjusting screw to ensure that the distance between the wheel tread and the brake block is 9.5 millimeters. In the A schedule of the axle box, check the axle box. Check the axle box for leakage of lubricants at covers, enclosures, and its housing joints. If any leakage is found, it should be thoroughly investigated and rectified. Also, check its wear plate. If any wear plate on the axle box or pedestals is cracked or missing, fit a new wear plate. In the A schedule of wheels, attend to incoming examination and driver's repair book. In the B schedule of wheels, measure the following parameters of all the loco wheels with their proper gauges. The root wear, the flange wear, the tread wear, and the wheel diameter. Measure the root wear of the wheel with the root wear gauge. It should be below 6 millimeters. Measure the flange wear of the wheel with a flange wear gauge. The flange wear should be less than 3 millimeters. And the tread wear, as measured by the tread wear gauge, should be less than 6.5 millimeters. If any of these readings have reached their critical level, send the wheel for reprofiling on the wheel pit lathe. Now, measure the wheel diameter of all the wheels on the locomotive using a J gauge. The wheel diameter must be 1092 millimeters in case of a new wheel and must not be below 1016 millimeters in case of service wheels. While fitting a new or reprofiled wheel, ensure that the maximum difference between wheel diameters are as follows. The difference between wheel diameter of any two wheels on the same axle in case of a new wheel should not be more than 0.5 millimeters and in case of service wheel should not be more than 1.6 millimeters. The difference between wheel diameter of any two wheels on the same bogey should not be more than 2 millimeters in case of new wheels and 6.4 millimeters in case of service wheels. And any two wheels on two different bogies of the same locomotive should not be more than 15 millimeters in case of new wheels and 25 millimeters in case of service wheels. In the A schedule of other undergear safety components, check the tightness of the beam safety bracket bolts. If any bolt is loose, tighten it properly. And seal it with wire. Check all the equalizing beams of the locomotive for cracks or shifting. In case of cracks, arrange to change the equalizing beam And in case any equalizing beam has shifted, adjust as required. Also check the center bolt. It should be secured and properly tightened. The split pin should be adequately opened. Then visually check the outer and the inner coil springs and their saddles. If there are cracks or any spring is damaged, arrange to replace the spring with a new one. Now visually examine the bogie horn stay plates. It should be properly fitted in the underframe and all the bolts should be fitted and properly tightened. Next, check the fixing arrangement of the brake pull rod safety bracket. All the nuts and bolts should be properly tightened. This is the secondary safety provision for the brake pull rod. Also ensure that the brake shoe tie rod beams are properly secured with their slings. Also check the CBC pin support plate. All the nuts and bolts on the plate should be fully tightened. Visually check the condition of the transition screw coupling. Also, operate the transition screw coupling with its operating handle. It should open and close smoothly. The CBC safety pin should also lock properly. In the B schedule of the other undergear safety components, lubricate the slack adjuster using a lubrication spray gun. Also check the center pivot casting and the side mounting loading pads. If the oil level is less, replenish with oil. In the C schedule of other undergear components, check the nuts and bolts and the bracket of the fuel tank mounting. If any bolt is loose, tighten or replace any missing bolt. Check the tightness of all the nuts and bolts of the cattle guard. Brackets and the rail guards. If any nut is loose, tighten. Also, if the cattle guard support rod is missing, fix a new cattle guard support rod. Examine the center buffer coupler and the side buffer for any fracture and wear. If any wear is found, change the coupler. After the scheduling of locomotive is complete, carry out a final check of the locomotive. Ensure that no component is in open position. All the joints must be intact, especially the fuel oil joint, the lube oil joint, and the water joint. Ensure that the safety guards of all the components are intact. Now start the locomotive and keep it at idle. Inspect the locomotive for any leakages. carry out an inspection of all the repairs and schedule items carried out during scheduling. Now bring the locomotive to its notch one by one. The vacuum gauge reading should not be less than 53 centimeters of mercury with test plate of 8 mm. And 56 centimeters of mercury on vacuum hose pipe dummy. Check the synchronization of brakes by application of A9 brakes. Ensure that all the brake piston travels are 67 mm and brakes apply on the wheels gradually. Ensure that no underframe part is hanging. All clamps and split pins are fully secured. Fill treated water up to maximum level in the water filling tank. Carry out these checks in engine idle position. Check thoroughly for any unusual sounds from the locomotive, especially the engine room, the expressor room, and the radiator room. The loading of the expressor should be at 8 kg per centimeter square, and the unloading of the expressor should be at 10 kg per centimeter square. Carry out these checks in the engine idle position. The expressor lube oil pressure should not be less than 3.2 kg per centimeter square. The vacuum pressure difference in the expressor crankcase and the vacuum train pipe should not be more than 5 inches of mercury. The blowing pressure of the air system safety valve should be 10.5 plus minus 0.1 kg per centimeter square, and its closing pressure should be 9.5 to 9.8 kg per centimeter square. In this training video film module, we have talked about the incoming examination of the diesel locomotive, the prescribed A, B, and C schedules of the engine and its related components, the expressor, the various assemblies of the radiator room, the air brake system, and the various components fitted in the undergear of the locomotive. In our next training video module, we will show you the prescribed A, B, and C schedules of the electrical sub-assemblies of the diesel-electric locomotive. पैनल में स्थित मीटर पैनल के एम्पियर मीटर व वोल्ट मीटर की जांच करें। यदि ये काम नहीं कर रहे हैं तो इन्हें बदलकर नए मीटर लगा दें। पावर पैनल में लगे अल्टरनेटर सिलेक्शन रोटरी स्विच और एसी प्लांट सिलेक्शन रोटरी स्विच की जांच करें। इन दोनों स्विचों को चारों पोजीशन पर घुमाकर देखें। यह चारों पोजीशन पर काम करने चाहिए। यदि किसी भी पोजीशन पर इलेक्ट्रिकल सप्लाई पास नहीं कर रही हो या स्विच जाम हो तो स्विच को बदल दें। हमेशा याद रखें, पावर पैनल का कोई भी कनेक्शन लोड पर गर्म नहीं होना चाहिए। पैनल का कोई भी फ्यूज जला हुआ या वायर फ्यूज नहीं होना चाहिए। यदि पावर पैनल में कोई एम्पियर या वोल्ट मीटर खराब हो या रोटरी स्विच कार्य नहीं कर रही हो तो उसे तुरंत बदल दें। मेंटेनेंस शेड्यूल के इस भाग में हमने आपको एसजीएसी कन्वेंशनल कोच के अंडर फ्रेम में लगे पावर जनरेशन उपकरण के देखरेख के बारे में बताया है। इस फिल्म की अगली श्रृंखला में हम आपको एसी सिस्टम के उपकरण की देखरेख की जानकारी देंगे।